Hey guys, how you going? Man, today's the fun part where everything's going to be added to the trailer. So we obviously start with small bits and pieces. As you can see today, we're going to fit all these goodies in the drawer. But yeah, basically in the previous video I had some trouble with the wheels. It was against the trailer, and so I ended up getting 25mm spaces. So as you can see, there's now a nice gap between the wheels and the trailer, which means it's gonna run freely without any restriction. So yeah, that's very good. But yeah, anyway guys, so for today, basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna install a spirit level on the trailer to make sure the trailer is nice and even when you park up for camping. You just wanna make sure it's even for future things that's coming to the trailer, and to make sure it's a good night. But anyway, next up is dust sealing basically. So I bought these rubbers that's gonna go on the outside of the trailer just to make it water resistant and dust proof, and also for the the latches, it's gonna go on the outside of the latches just to seal out all the dust as well, because you don't want to go on corrugated roads and then you open up your trailer and it's full of dust. Yeah, that's not fun. So we're gonna seal that off. And then also we're going to install the drawer, which is pretty cool. And it also came, because it's secondhand, it came with a weird modification, but it actually works pretty well. So we'll be able to use that modification and mount these 12-volt sockets into it, which means that's going to be perfect for the dual battery system. But yeah, without further ado, let's get into today's video. Also guys, you might want to stick to the end because I'm going to show you what my drawer setup looks like and everything on top of it. That's going to be a secret. So stay tuned, enjoy the video, let's get into it. Alrighty guys, so we'll start at the top first. So basically we're just going to use this tape, basically it's just a rubber, and that we're going to do around the edges, and then it's going to make it nice and sealable. So I just got this at Bunnings, it's like $15. I first went to Clark Rubber and it was like $100, so I was like, yeah, nah. So I went to Bunnings and $15. I mean, what a deal. So yeah, we're just gonna measure it up, put some glue on there, and then we're gonna tape it up and it will be sealed. Yeah, so let's get into that one. Alrighty, so I was planning on doing glue, but the tape is actually pretty good. So yeah, we'll just maybe stick it on there, see how long it lasts, and then if it comes off, I'll just run glue, but at the moment, it's pretty good. So yeah, I'll just put it on there like it is. Another cool thing too is that, so that's 5 centimeters, and so this side is 3 and that side is 2, so it works out pretty good to cut it and to make it fit either way. So yeah, make sure you buy it the right size at Bunnings. Always go and measure up your trailer first before you go buy it, and in that way it works out seamlessly. Well, as you can see, it looks pretty good, so I'm very happy with the end result. Yeah, so it looks pretty good, and it also closes nicely. So there it starts to seal, and then when you push down and you're gonna lock it, then that's gonna be very tight and sealed, so no dust is getting in this bad boy. So yeah, let's do the other side, and yeah, then we'll continue with the next job. Alrighty guys, so we just finished with the top box. We're now going to do the outsides of this trailer as well, just to make sure everything is nice and sealed, and then we'll focus on the backside on a later stage. I'm not too sure what I'm going to do there, but we'll figure it out, and then yeah, we'll get into the drawer. Alrighty guys, so it's time to do the drawer, which is pretty exciting. So basically we're just gonna mount it in here so it's flush against the trailer. And here's the weird modification I talked about, but it actually works in our favor. So what I'm gonna do is take the other 12 volt sockets, which is the same as those ones, and just mount it at the top over there in there somewhere, just so it's close to the battery that's gonna sit on here. So yeah, let's get straight into it. Alrighty guys, so just quickly before it dries up, I just used Silkaflex 227, as you can see over there, hopefully, just around the edges of the holes that I drilled, just so it doesn't rust out. But yeah, we're gonna bolt the drawer into the floor now, just to make it tidy and steady, I guess. So yeah, let's quickly do that. Just want to show you a cool trick over here. So there's no one to help me, you know, tighten up these bolts. So what you do is you take a spanner, all right, just place it over the bolt like that, and then when you go underneath and you tighten it up, it's actually going to go against the bracket over there, so that means it will tighten up nicely. I'll show you how in a second. Okie dokie guys, so that is all bolted down now. So as you can see, this thing's not going anyway, so that's pretty good. We're gonna put the lid on and the drawer inside, and then yeah, go from there. Well, there you go guys, look at that. So the drawer is in, it's nice and steady. Yeah, you also want to make sure when you close that up, it's actually going to fit. because there's this handle over here that can be in the way, so just measure up nicely. And yeah, we just need to bolt this thing down. So normally there's like a gap, but the owner, well, the previous owner gave this. So just gonna screw that down and then it will look nice and flash. Look at that. But yeah, and then we'll get into this one, just mount it in there, then it should be all right. Alrighty guys, so I was about to install this one, but I'm actually not too sure whether that's the best place to put it, because you're gonna have wires everywhere. Like if it's there, it's gonna be like, you know, it's not gonna be practical at all. So I reckon I might put everything into the trailer, and once everything is in, I might find a new place for it. For instance, like putting it there or somewhere where it will be more practical, because at the moment I don't think that's going to be too good. Another thing, I had to remove this one. It was a tiny bit too thick, so that's probably like 10 mil, so I would go for one that's like 5 mil, just so it closes more effectively. It closed, but it was very tight, so yeah, I'd rather just, you know, do it over. It's all right to make mistakes, just do it right. But yeah, anyway guys, so the last thing we're gonna do is just install these spirit levels. So basically that is just to make sure when I arrive at camp then the trailer is level, because I plan to put a rooftop tent on there. So yeah, you don't want to sleep on an angle or anything, you want to sleep straight. So yeah, we're gonna install that, and then I'll show you the setup that I have in the trailer with the deal battery and everything that's gonna go on the drawer. So yeah, let's do this one. Alrighty guys, so that brings us to the end of this episode. But before I go, I'm gonna show you guys what I've done with the drawer. Because that was like kept a secret for today, so here it is. So as you can see, there's a beautiful deal air compressor. I got that from Repco. It's only about 99 bucks. It was an absolute bargain. But yeah, so basically what I've done, then there's my deal battery. Used some king springs, so this battery is really solid. Used the tie down points, and yeah, so that can't go anywhere, and same with the air compressor. So yeah, that's pretty neat. Super happy with it. So yeah, I'm very excited to get all the other goodies in there. But yeah, that's basically it for today guys. Thanks so much for joining in. There's obviously a few stuff that I need to fix up, so things like over here, like fixing that up, but that's all good. And then also trying to figure out what I'm gonna do with the back and to keep the dust out. But yeah, overall thanks for watching. And what do you guys reckon I should do with the 12 volt sockets? Where can I put it? And what would you guys do? Is there any recommendations you guys would want to see that I do with this trailer? Yeah, let me know in the comments below. See you next week where the mods continue. Cheers, have a good one.